I'm live. Hi, everyone. So I'm happy to be back once again. And I'd like to say good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to wherever you are watching us live at this very moment. Before I move on, let me first introduce myself. My name is Ellen, and I'm from the Philippines. Mabuhay! I'm a mother of two growing kids, a finance professional, a proud digital business owner, and a business mentor. So today, I'm excited to have a guest who's really, a dad. I'm going first to show you what I have, made so that you will be able to see a bigger picture of Ryan. So my guest today is really from Cebu City. In Cebu City, Philippines, and Ryan is a dad of a baby, almost 1 year old soon, a nurse educator, an online business owner, and a business mentor. So, I'm so happy in this episode because I'm sharing and praying that we are inspiring people from from our viewers and followers to see how our digital business owner dads and moms and parents who are actually doing full-time jobs or stay-home parents but at the same time running their online business on the side. And I'm actually happy to showcase to them how they do their everyday happy life in our situation today. So I'm going to introduce you to my guest. I'm so happy and blessed to have him, and I'm really excited. And hi, Ryan. How
hi,
are
sis.
You? How
oh,
are
I'm
you?
Fine. I'm fine.
Thanks a lot.
I have a
thanks
good
a
day.
lot. Thanks a lot. First, I'd like to say thank you for agreeing to this show. I know you're so busy and you're doing your, of course, full-time job, and you're an educator nurse. I'd like to say, tell me about your life, prior to joining this online business. What was your life? What was Ryan doing?
Okay, so basically,
you can
I'm...
greet first your followers and your friends before saying
hello to my friends and also to my global friends. Good evening from the Philippines. Good morning in the US. I think it's morning in the US right now.
I know, we're global business.
Yeah, good afternoon from the UK and Middle East. So this is Ryan Alexander Lim. I'm a dad, a proud digital business owner, and a nurse by profession. So by the way, I graduated 2005, sis. Then after the graduation, I took the board exam, and then unluckily I was not accepted in the hospital because of the competition, I think competition. And then in the Philippines, sis, we need backer in order to to go inside the hospital. But I know God has plans for me. So when I took the risk of applying being a lecturer or an educator, I was hired immediately. So I think, oh, this is a good life. And you know what, sis? My first assignment, I don't know if you know this one, I was assigned in Zamboanga City.
Oh, I'm from Zamboanga.
Yeah, when I look at your profile, oh, she's from Zamboanga. That's my first assignment. But after 2 months of being in Zamboanga, I was assigned again in Bacolod and Iloilo. So, like there, as a new graduate or as a new life is so happy. And then I was really happy is because you are a lecturer in the Philippines, you have free hotel accommodation and free plane accommodation.
That's so nice. That's great.
Yeah, that's why I was enjoying. So I enjoyed my job. I love my job. And then perhaps the business side or the business blood in us really reigned because aside from being a lecturer, I venture into some side hustle, like, for example, a small piggery. We have a backyard piggery, but it was run by my mother. And then after, I don't know, 3 years,
Interesting.
it was good. Yeah, it was good, but it was too tasking for my mother. That's why we stopped it. And we have another venture, sand and gravel. But during the pandemic, we were affected with the pandemic because what happened is there were boundaries. So we were not allowed to get sand and gravel to some other places because our supplier is another province. So we are from my mother right now and father is in Leyte right now. So northern and southern Leyte, there's a boundary. So you cannot go there. So oh my God, I think I thought that it will not be affected by the pandemic, the sand and gravel, but it was. So
Oh,
there
okay.
were lots of, there were lots of roadblocks and but right now we are back on track. We are back on track. But this pandemic really taught us that we need to have a plan B and we need to have a pandemic-proof business. So aside from the businesses, I'll go back. Me and my wife, we are fan of going places. We are fan of going beaches, traveling. In fact, we tag ourselves as
Oh, I love
Laagan
that. Onion is like nomads,
Laaga. Yeah. But it's a Bisaya term, so
yeah, it's
Lagan couple because
similar.
we really love to travel. In fact, supposed to be we have traveled last year, March, going to Macau, but it was canceled.
Yeah, because of
So,
the pandemic.
yeah, yes, because of the
We have
pandemic, it was canceled. How about you, sis?
That's really, I mean, typical of young couples, right? I know you love traveling. We first have to greet our live tuners. We have, of
Yeah.
course, Nifel from Bisleg City. I don't know if nagpronounce ako
Oh.
ng maayos. And then, of course, Sharon from California. Hello, California people.
Ah.
And
That's
then
my mentor,
Donna.
sis. That's my
Oh,
mentor.
hi, Sharon, mentor
Wow.
of Brother Ryan. And of course, we also have Donna from Canada. Hi, sis. And of course, Aji from Bulacan and Chrysler from Davao City. And we have also from Virginia. Wow. I love people from the USA because my sister works in the US also. And then Mylene from Virginia, USA. And
Yeah, yeah.
thank you so much,
Hi,
guys,
Sis
for watching us.
Mylene.
And I know we are in different time zones, and they're actually in the morning there, and we are
Wow.
evening here in the part of the world. But of course, these are actually the business owners who are really, trying to see what we are doing at this point in time because we are such a global community. And we are always supporting each other. And I'm so what I can recall my younger days while I was your age, probably me and my husband actually also are into those. But at this time, of course, it's pandemic, and we have our
Yeah.
teenagers. We are already, of course, tied to family matters. It's good that you're actually starting that because when you're into younger years, you're traveling. That will already set the mode and the tone in your life moving forward, right? Because when you have kids,
Yeah.
especially you have a baby now, you will be tied with a lot of daddy matters. And of course, when they're growing, there's just a portion of time that you will be traveling because there's a whole lot of things you will be bringing if they're just babies. For example, when I was having my babies, like they're just 13 months apart, it's quite a challenge for me to be going outside the country because of a lot of logistics, things that I need to do. But when they're older a bit, that's when we started going outside, of
Yeah.
course, traveling. So I'm so happy to hear that, Ryan, that you have, active and busy life, and that was your life. So now we will be asking you, as you do your daily activities in your day-to-day life, as a dad to your what baby, and of course a nurse educator who's busy with a lot of what you know, learnings and sharings with your students, and of course on the side a business owner and a mentor. What can you give us the top three practical tips doing your day-to-day life?
Okay, sis. So as a nurse and as a dad right now, so one of my three practical tips are, number one, we have to be professional and committed to our job. So being a nurse educator, I'm committed to work to give my 100% to my students for them to enable to pass their respective exam, be it in the local board exam and in NCLEX. So NCLEX is a considered a, and this is a an abroad type of exam for the US. So another one is being professional means being mindful of the time. You know what, sis, before I never have I'm never late in doing classes, especially face to face. But right now, due to technical issues, technical issues, because sometimes the internet is so slow or my laptop is so slow, so I cannot get inside with the Zoom. So I told myself, why am I I'm late with this kind of technology? I'm just at home and then I'm late. Then during the time when it's still face to face, I cannot think of a time that I'm late, because being late is one of the thing that I really value, because time is valuable to my students. Same as with the business also. So aside from that one, it was really my attitude that keeps me in this industry, being an educator. Then sometimes I remember I have a joke that so sobrang committed ko, I even encountered life, natural and man-made disaster. Like for example, in Zamboanga, you know what? I was there when the Zamboanga siege happened.
Oh, really? Oh, I was in my school then. We were in the school.
Yeah, I was there, but we were just changed to some other places so that, because I think that was in the heart of the city, and then our review center was located, it was located near the city hall. So we were transferred, we were transferred outside the city in order to continue with the review. But the parents, the parents of the students were not allowed. So there were no review for, I think that was about 2 weeks. We stopped the review and then we resume on, I think that was October. Yeah. Because the siege happened in September 24. And then...
unforgettable experience, bro.
That was my most unforgettable experience being a lecturer.
It's life-threatening as well.
Yeah, because I thought, oh my God, can I go back home safely with this? Then I just prayed in the hotel. Yeah. And you can just imagine this. I can hear the bomb.
The firing guns of the people.
Yeah.
The military versus the rebels, right?
Yeah. So the good thing that when it was already clearing operations, the good thing, that's good. Then I can really see, sis, that Zamboanga is a nice place, because you just only need to walk, and then sometimes I don't ride the motorcycle, because it's expensive. It's 40 pesos.
Oh, expensive.
It seems like a taxi.
Oh.
Yeah. Then I also remember this one instance that from Luzon going to Manila, I encountered a typhoon in the middle of my trip within the bus. So we were just only four in the bus. I remember the bus is Victory Liner. We're just four in the bus. So that's how committed I am with work.
That's really good advice.
You have to be committed and you have to be professional in your work. So same with the business. You need to show up with the business and you need to work hard. So the second tip that I can give to our followers and friends around the globe is be persistent and be patient. So as an educator, the industry was booming 2007 to 2009. It was like, sis, I was like, the Tagalog term is buhay hari that time, because we have so many students that I I do lecture with 400 students, sis, and then we do the lecture in the hotel. That sometimes I cannot go home because I have, for example, in some other places, I work there for 2 months. So it seems like a vacation at the same time, work and vacation. Then when I will go home to Cebu, they still give me the hotel. So I told them that I need to go home because I was not able to see my family for a few months. So I had to go home. But it was also, they told me that, sir, you have a room here. So it will be in Tagalog, it's sayang if you will not use the room. So I told him, okay, I'll bring my family here in
so
Crown
this is a
Regency.
Nice job you have.
Yeah.
Actually, that's a nice, nice job.
Yeah, it's
pleasure
yeah,
and learning at the same time.
Yeah, then starting 2014, there was the number of nurses or student nurses dwindled. So it came to a realization that life really is like a cycle, same like with that sometimes you are at the top, then sometimes you are at the bottom. So you need to move forward. So whatever will happen, you have to move forward. So if you really want to succeed in life, get what you want, you need to practice delayed gratification. So I can also apply this one, sis, because when I was courting my wife, I'm proud to say that it almost took me 2 years before she said yes.
Yes. It's worth
so
the waiting.
See how persistent I am.
It's worth the waiting. And yeah, you are really a persistent guy. And look at you now. You have a happy family with your baby. And, you know, it's just really, that's your number to tip. Be persistent and be patient. It's just a lot about how you can become, achieving this and being successful to your goal because you are persistent and is patient.
Yes, yeah, we have to practice through times, but with this, in relation to the business right now, I can say that it's really applicable. All my traits, being persistent and being patient, is really applicable in the business because, as we all know, the business, this digital business, is not an overnight success. And I can assure you, it's not a get-quick-rich scheme. So that's why it's very applicable. And the third one is the tip. This is the one that also I love, being prayerful. I know I'm not that religious, but the influence of my mother, being a religious person, it was passed to me. So although I'm not that very, very religious, but I prayed because
that.
I really believe that prayer moves mountain. And then, of course, here in Cebu, we have Santo Niño.
Oh, yeah. Santo Niño is very miraculous.
It's very miraculous. And we believe in that one, in Santo Niño. So same with the business. At first, I was really aggressive with the digital business. But when the roadblocks and bumps along the way are coming, I never give up. So I have God. I let God do it. I let God take control of it. So I took the pressure because at first, I was really pressured because I want to be aggressive with the business. And then after some roadblocks happen, I realized that I will let God do control it. Then I just pray and sometimes took off the pressure. Yeah, and enjoy the journey. Yeah, that's the beauty
really
of
true.
Business.
Because you know, as we have to acknowledge first Sis Olive who's watching. Hi, Sis Olive, good evening.
Hi, Sis Olive.
So we're actually, you know, hearing your stories on being a, and also Wilma. Wilma, my friend. Hi, Wilma. So, you know, hearing your story and your tips on how to you do your everyday life, which is, you know, being committed, being persistent, and being patient. And you also, of course, everyone needs praying. Everyone needs praying, especially at this time. You know, we cannot control anything that things that happen like one we are experiencing now. what we can do is just let go and let God. And that's really, you know, the way we do our daily lives is letting go and letting God control our circumstance, our challenges. So with that, I know you have been, you know, you have been busy and at the same time practicing this day-to-day activities with your tips. What are the changes then that happened to you when you joined this digital business? I mean, from your life before to now, what are those changes that you can share?
Okay, so one of the major changes that happened in my life after being a digital business owner is having that positive mindset and being grateful. That's the first one, because we were allowed to read book, and it was my first time to read The Magic. So it helps a lot to me to attract abundance. Then it helped me focus on the things that I have and do not focus on the things that I don't have. So even the small things is, like for example, waking up in the morning is already a great blessing for me, because I realized when pandemic hit, there were last August, I think, patients were lining up in the hospital, then their cars together with the oxygen beside. Then one thing I learned, oh my God, oxygen is so expensive. Even the tank of the oxygen is already 8,000, because our president here in our subdivision bought a tank, because in case of emergency, we need an oxygen here. Anybody from the subdivision will have the oxygen. So even the tank is already 8,000. So that's why I realized that, oh my God, the oxygen that was given by God to us is free. And then we have to be thankful for it. So having that positive mindset is the core foundation of this business, not only with this business, but with my life. It really changed my life, sis. Then second one, another positive change that came into is the time management. Because you know what? I have a busy life. So 8 to 5, I have work. Then sometimes I have a job. I have a job 8 to 12 midnight. That's for my NCLEX review. So I will be reviewing students from abroad, like for example, US, UK, Australia. So we did that one by 8 to 12 midnight. And then I have this part-time job also of doing some doing some questions for the NCLEX. I was invited in the NCLEX, how to do the questions and something like that. So right now, I'm enrolling in master's right now, because I want to finish my master's. So I really don't know how to juggle. But with this type of, with the digital business, I learn how to manage my time. I tend to be productive and motivated to get things done. So this business has taught me to work smarter, set daily and monthly goals in life. And another one that positive changes in my life is never be afraid to fail. Because I remember one of our panelists from one of our MM or mastermind, they told us, it's a couple, they told us that the faster you fail, the faster you will go, or the faster that you will be successful
succeed.
In life. Yeah, or the faster you will succeed in life. So right now, I see failure as an opportunity. So I developed that growth mindset of seeing that failure as an opportunity, a part of being better. So growth does not happen when everything is perfect. Sometimes it happens when you experience obstacles and still keeps moving forward. So that was also instilled by my mentor. So I'm really happy, and I'm so grateful to my mentor, who always keeps me motivated and have that discipline to keep on going. And the last thing is gaining lots of global friends. So I never thought that I will have so many friends globally. So we meet virtually, like you, sis.
Yeah, I know.
It's my first time to meet you, but it's virtual, but it's very sincere. Yeah.
Yeah, it's really... That's a lot of beauty, right? In doing this business, right? As you said, you learn to be grateful. Of course, aside from the financial or the monetary blessings that come with the business, because we go for business to earn profit and to make money, right? But as you said, I just noticed all of these are actually things that are already, part of it if we are able to see the beauty of the business is you're being grateful for the life every day, you're able to manage your time, you are not afraid to fail, and you, of course, gaining global friends. So these are actually wealth in itself, right? Because if we are not able to look at them as, part of our blessings, part of the positive things happening in our life, then it will be difficult to look at even far greater achievements because blessings are given in trickles, right? And are given in a way that we appreciate little things. So I'm just so, of course, blessed that like you, I'm also able to see all these kind of things. And it's not just me, even you, right? And gaining global friends, especially in our time zone, when I was like, as I told before, I don't have any, say we are in the Philippines, everybody's sleeping at, late night, but I can always ask question in other parts of the world because they are still up and awake. So it's just a message away. Other, Filipinos are sleeping at this time. I'm quite shy to ask, it's late. We have a community here, but I can ask other countries and community friends, right? And global
Yeah, that's
friends
the
before
beauty,
them.
sis. I also learned that once, sis, that I need to think of the time zone in the US. Then I realized, okay, perhaps the one that I will be messaging is still awake that time. So
That's the beauty of
you
it.
need to respect them also. They respect their time and be courteous to them.
Yeah, so I really thank you so much. These are items that I actually would be love to hear from digital business owners because these are actually nuggets of wisdom that we learn from our co-business owners like you, Ryan. Now we are meeting online and we are sharing ideas and we are sharing the positive sides of happening in our life. As you said, especially you are young, you are still young, try to fail as much as you can because it's only through failing that you can learn things. So for me, of course, I'm already in the bit side of the quadrant, but of course, everything is learning. And if there's sometimes there are things that we cannot be successful and beyond our control, we can charge it to learning experience, right? So it's important that, like this kind of sharing, we are actually learning at the same time. So, I'm so thankful, Ryan, for having this night, this
Conversation.
time, sharing your nuggets of wisdom. And we will say that for those who are, listening to our stories, who are watching this, wherever you are right now, and you are still thinking of, and this story resonates with your story, then you can check out our, you can check out our site if you are, your story resonates with us because this is kind of opportunity that is, I would say, the business of the 21st century because we are just at home and we are actually in our own space. And as like Ryan, he's having his full time, and most of the business community owners are actually full-time workers, meaning they have their day job, they have their night job, and at the same time having this on the side. So just as I said, we're here to offer solutions and offer what's actually can be an opportunity and a side hustle, right? It can
Yes,
be
sis.
sometimes, that will bring you to your life later to transition, especially my advocacy, Ryan, is helping working moms and parents to transition to full-time
Full time.
stay-home moms and stay-home
Yeah.
parents, because I would
Yeah.
say that the benefits of staying parents at home supporting children is just way beyond what we can imagine. And so I just hope that those now watching us will, try to see what is the business all about, and just can check the website to see if the, the story of our stories are, of course, resonating with them. So Ryan, I will not keep you long. I know you have a baby to take care. What are your words to our viewers that you can say about anything that you would have to say on this, on having this life that you have right now?
Okay, sis. So basically, at first, I was really skeptical when I registered on this one. But when I went in, it's a really great business, guys, and it's world class. It's world class that, although I can say that is there's automation, but it's not that fully automated, but it's you were given 90% already were done. And you have to do your 10%,
your own,
or
of
yeah,
course.
Your own. Of course, you have to do your own part in order for the business to prosper. And then at first, sis, I was really my goal is to have that second stream of income, but as months go along, my perspective changed, and it was changed to being helpful to another family. So for those who are planning to have the side hustle, moms and dads, if you are dreaming of having a good and quality life with your family as well as your kids, so this could be the business that is good for you. So all you have to do is register on our website. You can register on Sis Ellen or my website. My website,
yeah,
by
you
the way,
put it.
is www. Can I say
Sure,
it?
sure. I was even asking why you did not put it. You can put it there. I can put it in a chat box so that they can click on it.
www.ryanalexanderlim.com.
Yeah.
That's my
Ryan Alexander.
ryanalexanderlim.com. That's my website. So if our stories resonates with you, so you can check it out and just watch the webinar. The webinar is the first step to let you know if this business is for you or not. So there's nothing to lose, but everything to gain. I think that's it, sis.
That's really, really nice parting words. And of course, we'd like to invite them tomorrow for a live info session. It's going to be 8 o'clock in the Philippines time, and it's going to be 8 p.m. EST.
Yes,
Eastern Standard Time. I will put it in the chat box later. And then, of course, 6 p.m. MST or Mountain Standard Time, in about 5 p.m. PST, Pacific Standard Time. So I will, of course, put it in the chat box. And thanks, guys. We also have Gina. I cannot pronounce the name.
Daya,
Gina, right? Daya Casiles. Thanks, sisters, for watching. And I hope that, we learn something from the, the show or the video live today, and inspire our stories, of course, especially Ryan's story, for you to see if this is something for you as well, because this is going to be another kind of, aside from monetary and financial, is another kind of a learning experience, especially at this time that we are at home, right? So thanks a lot, guys, for watching. And for those who are watching from anywhere around the world, would like to say good morning, good afternoon, and good evening. And thank you, guys, for watching, and stay safe and well. Bye for now. Okay, bye for now, guys. Thanks
okay,
a lot.
Bye-bye.
See
Thank you,
you.
Sis. Thank you.